The scripture reading this morning is from 2 Corinthians, the 5th chapter, beginning with verse 13. If you wish to follow in the Pew Bible, it's in the New Testament on page 181. Excuse me. For if we are beside ourselves, it is for God. If we are in our right mind, it is for you. For the love of Christ urges us on because we are convinced that one has died for all. Therefore, all have died. And he died for all so that those who live might live no longer for themselves, but for him who died and was raised for them. From now on, therefore, we regard no one from a human point of view, even though we once knew Christ from a human point of view. We know him no longer in that way. So if anyone is in Christ, there is a new creation. Everything old has passed away. See, everything has become new. All this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ and has given us the ministry of reconciliation. That is, in Christ, God was reconciling the world to himself, not counting their trespasses against them, and entrusting the message of reconciliation to us. So we are ambassadors for Christ. Since God is making his appeal through us, we entreat you on behalf of Christ, be reconciled to God. For our sake, he made him to be sin who knew no sin, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Well, first of all, I want you to realize that today is more about singing our praise to God. So I have prepared a short meditation, so don't panic. I'm not going to preach a full sermon. In Jesus, there is an advent, the coming of something. And this advent of something coming changed the world. As you heard read, the scriptures teach everything old has passed away. See, everything has become new. All creation has been changed because of the advent of Jesus. Even the Grinch. This Sunday after Christmas, as I've already stated, we focus on singing of carols as a way of celebrating that the old has passed away and the new has come. And the promise of everything being made new in Jesus Christ. You know, Revelation 20 is one of my favorite passages of Scripture because it talks precisely about that, how God is making everything new. Now, I recognize that sometimes we may not feel very new. We may feel like the Grinch. We may feel a bit grumpy during the holiday season. And like the Grinch, we may not even know why. But the old has passed and the new has come. Now, as a person coming from a science background, I really appreciated when Matt Rawl drew on string theory to make a point. And if you had a chance to read the book, or if you don't know what string theory is, in a very, very nutshell kind of thing, is a theory that everything is made up of teeny tiny vibrating strings. And the frequency at which that string vibrates determines what kind of atomic particle it's going to be. And it seemed to me Rawl was postulating that when a person, because we're made up of these strings, when a person is vibrating in harmony with God, that's when we experience joy. He draws attention to how a song written in a major chord usually causes our spirits to feel very light and joyful. And conversely, he talks about how hymns and songs written in a minor chord tend to evoke feelings of sadness. In other words, again, I want to stress, when one is in tune with God, one has an experience of joy. And I think Raw is implicating that depending on how often we're in tune with God is how much joy we experience. And I want to point out, this is part of the promise of everything being made new. Everything made new vibrates in tune with God, and there is joy. Now, I want to also remind you of this. Never forget that this promise of the old passing and the new coming, this is not just a promise for the future. It certainly is a promise for the future, but it's also a promise for the here and now. You know, one thing that really caught me in this last chapter of Matt Rawl's book was the statement he made about joy. Do you remember what that statement is he wrote about joy? He said, "Joy is a flash of eternity." That really resonated with my being, because I never thought of joy that way. Joy is a flash of eternity. It's a glimpse of eternity. It's a glimpse of what heaven is like. It's a glimpse of what could be, and I believe what can be, here on earth. Remember, Jesus said the kingdom of God is near. It's not far away. It's near. And I personally believe God has given us everything we need for the world to live in peace, harmony, and joy. Now, I'll be the first to admit, do I do those things very well sometimes? No. I wish I could. I'd like to say I try, but I very frequently fail. But that's just because we still live in a broken, fallen world. But don't forget, this is not just some future pie in the sky thing. And God gives us glimpses of joy, flashes of eternity, so that we may know what eternity is like. You know, I remember, this was before I was in ministry, but I remember someone saying to the pastor of my home church, "We sing too much. I don't like all this singing we do. I want to hear more preaching." And you know, without missing a beat, the pastor said, "Are you sure?" He said, "I don't think you're going to be very happy in heaven then if you don't like singing." Because God uses music, as you well know, God uses music as a way to speak to us. And it's in that sense that music really is a universal language. There don't even have to be words, and God can speak to us through music. So I've really latched on to this thing, and music, that's why I wanted to sing today. Has it been a joyful experience for you to sing the Christmas hymns?
Yes.
I was going to say, I hope I didn't miss that one. But me too, I was looking forward to this day when we could spend time just singing and experiencing the joy, because when we sing God's praises, we are vibrating in the same frequency. We are vibrating in harmony with God, and we get that flash of joy that is eternity. Music is God's way of demonstrating to us that the old has indeed passed and the new has come. And you know, maybe that's one reason why so many people's attitudes change for the better during Christmas. They're experiencing a glimpse of the everlasting joy of being in harmony and in the presence of Almighty God. And you know, I think that's part of what happened to the Grinch in our book. In his conversion experience, the Grinch saw a flash of eternity when, you remember? When he heard the Who's singing, remember? It's when he heard the Who's singing that his heart was changed and it began to grow. I think Dr. Seuss also gives us a glimpse of eternity in the reconciliation of the Grinch and the Who's. You know, it could have been a very worldly story where the Who's stormed up the mountain with the proverbial torches and pitchforks and took back their stuff from the Grinch. But that's not what happened. Instead of seeking revenge, the Who's welcomed the Grinch. And not only that, they gave him the place of honor at the table of the feast. And I want to conclude by saying, whether one has ever thought about it or not, the tale of how the Grinch stole Christmas, while it is not overtly Christian, it is an Advent story. It's a story about why Jesus came to earth. It's a story about why Jesus suffered and died. It's a story about resurrection, redemption, and making all things new. I've come to realize, and maybe you have too, that how the Grinch stole Christmas is really a modern-day parable about the good news of Jesus Christ. By the way, how the Grinch stole Christmas just happens to be on television tonight, and I plan on watching it. But I'm planning on watching it through a new lens. I'm planning on watching it through a new lens now that I have a fresh perspective on the timeless story of how the Grinch stole Christmas, the fresh perspective given to me by Matt Rawl in our study. And my prayer for all of us, if you want to join me in watching it tonight at your home, I don't want to walk out the door and have my wife said, "You did what?" But I pray in watching it, maybe we can catch a flash of eternity. Amen. Amen. No more let sin and sorrows grow, nor thorns infest the ground. Sounds to me like, I guess I shouldn't cover up my mic, sounds to me like we have a choice to make there. God has made all things new, but we still live in a broken and fallen world where sin, sickness, and death have sway. But we have a choice. I have a choice to not allow those things to steal our joy, just as those kind of things stole the joy of the Grinch. So go forth knowing you are a blessed people simply because God loves you. Enough that he gave his one and only Son, that he might become incarnate, to live among us, to teach us, to die for us, to rise for us. And he too gives us a glimpse, a flash of eternity. So go forth in the coming year looking for those flashes of eternity. If we could all do that, if I could do that, how might that change our lives? Go forth in the peace of Christ and share the good news of Jesus with all you meet. Amen. Please be seated, and after the postlude, depart in the peace of Jesus Christ.